The MJF promo. Back in the campaign headquarters, we have to endure 20 minutes of what we just watched, but this we get a 2-minute pre-tape. He fired all the campaign workers. Good riddance. He's mad at Wardlow. This was a great performance, as usual, from MJF, but at least in this, they also somewhat established that MJF pays Wardlow and he has motivation for being a stooge, even though he doesn't like it. Of course, they're still, you know, teasing us way too soon because everything, you know, 3 weeks on television and you're instantly over. That's what they think. But at least we got some of the motivation with Wardlow. He's paying him. His family may be in fucking financial difficulty. Your family be out in the street, whatever the fuck. Wardlow's going to bear up under this. It was what it was, and it was one of the highlights of the night in this reprehensible program. And I know you don't like the campaign, so I'm sure you're glad to see the campaign workers go.
I didn't like anything about the buildup and way they handled Moxley versus MJF, other than the promos they did during the contract signing, which were then negated by the lawyer getting involved. So I'm happy that MJF's getting rid of the campaign. I think a serious MJF would get fantastic heat amongst that crowd, the smart-ass AEW crowd. He's so good. He's
yes.
So talented. There's no need for bad comedy with MJF. With that said,
because he does his own good comedy in his promos. Yeah. Good comedy is stuff that still gets heat with that audience because they know he's telling the truth when he says cosplay this and fucking knocks them all and he rips them to shreds.
It's similar to you doing promos on TBS in the 80s. You were yes. funny, but you weren't doing comedy like goofy skits and goofy scenarios.
Most of the people were mad because, as the old saying goes, you can tell a fat wife joke and everybody fucking laughs at it except for the guy whose wife is fat. I was knocking people that the fans liked, so therefore they were not amused.
Now, with that said, as talented as I think he is and how much I'm happy and how happy I am that getting rid of the campaign shit, this is now the second start to this teasing dissension with him and Wardlow. And I really don't like that. I think these two guys should be together for a lot longer. And if they are not going to break up for a long while, I hate the fact that they're teasing this now again.
Yeah.
But those are my only thoughts about this.
Well, that's when you tease it too soon, you make the big guy look like a fucking putz when he doesn't switch or turn or say no. Like on Planet of the Apes, when, you know, in a reasonable amount of time. But at the same time, as we've mentioned in the past, it's not a bitter fucking divorce if you've only been dating for 2 weeks. So they haven't been together long enough anyway, but nobody has any patience. And at least if they break up, we'll get some more good promos.
What about the idea that MJF's supporting Wardlow and his family? That if I stop paying you, your family will be out on the street.
Well, if they can, I mean, obviously Wardlow is a big, giant professional wrestler that ought to be able to make a living, but if they can figure some kind of way to make it believable that he's under some type of burdensome indentured servitude contract that he was bilked into signing and can't get out of it to do something else unless, you know, whatever. But I'm giving him way too much credit for coming up with this shit. Anyway. And then we moved on to talking, but it was better than the wrestling on this program. Moxley was in apparently a public park restroom entrance this time. I don't know. George Michael didn't peep around the corner, but it was concrete, just a concrete hallway. It looks to me like the experiences I've had in the past with a public park restroom. Don't ask me.
Anyway. I think now they're just doing it to get you to say something, because he's in a ridiculous location.
Next week, I want him to be like laying flat of his back under a bed.
I want to see him
just turn to the right.
I want to see him laying on the lawn.
Yeah. Anyway, as usual, it was a great promo. If his matches were any good and he looked like the badass he talks like, he'd be fucking great. Let's move on.